Australia, are you with us? Come on. Sorry about that. As I was just about to introduce, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome our legendary band, Jethro Tull.
As I did walk by Hampstead Fair, I came upon Mother Goose. So I turned her loose while she was screaming. And a foreign student said to me, was it really true? There are elephants and lions too in Piccadilly Circus. Try and catch some sun. Must have been 100 schoolgirls sobbing into handkerchiefs as one. I don't believe they knew I was a schoolboy. And a bearded lady said to me, if you start your raving and you're misbehaving, you'll be sorry. And the chicken fancier came to play with his long red beard, and his sister's weird, she drives a lorry.
We've got Andy Giddings and Martin Barr. Welcome.
Hi.
One and all.
Thank you.
Oh, I love that.
Yeah,
in there, Ian.
Especially this time of the morning.
It is a bit difficult. It is actually just early afternoon. Maybe
yes,
you're probably
right.
Still on jet lag. Is that right, Ian?
She improvised hastily. Yes, exactly the reason that I said that. Yes, it's sometime early in the morning, like the early hours of the morning, where we just came from.
Somewhere in the world.
Yeah, long journey. Long way back home from England.
Well, welcome. After 27 years of Jethro Tull, Ian, what's the profile of a Jethro Tull fan?
These days, I would say it's pretty much there are two separate generations of people out there, because of the folk who grew up with Jethro Tull, who are nearly as old as we are, and then there's a different bunch of folks who are probably, you know, late teens, early 20s, who missed out on all that first time around and are now the curious fun seekers coming to see what it was their parents spent all that money and time listening to.
And they grew up on.
And, well, if they weren't hallucinating too badly at the time, yes.
You do have a lot of fun, and I love the way you play the flute there, which is, you know, synonymous with Jethro Tull. I would never have put flute with a hard rock and roll band, but you beg to differ.
Well, I wouldn't either, no. It's a thankless task trying to play a nice little gentle acoustic instrument like that with these very noisy people.
Some of the stuff you do is big rock and roll. It's not only the sort of acoustic version we've heard today of Jethro Tull.
That's right. Well, the term these days, everyone talks about music that is unplugged. Well, that's what I've been doing for 28 years. I'm the unplugged guy who's in a rock and roll band, because I would play the acoustic instruments, you know, the acoustic guitar, the mandolin, the flutes, the nice gentle things made of wood and folky sort of instruments. Mm. But in the rock context, that's always been the style of music people associate with us.
And even the generational gap has caught up with you, because the flute and your daughter have something in common as well.
That they're both very expensive, yes. He said, improvising wildly. No, my daughter actually started playing flute at school, being obliged to take up some kind of an instrument. So she came home and said, "Daddy, will you buy me an instrument to play at school?" I said, "Sure, what do you fancy?" She said, "Well, what should I play?" I said, "Well, leave out things like cellos and violins, they're really hard. Try a saxophone or a flute, they're kind of easy." Sorry, guys over there, but they are. And she said, "Well, will you buy me a saxophone?" I said, "No, but I'll lend you a flute."
A cheap daddy.
So I polished one up and lent it to her, and then she came back and told me I was doing it all wrong. And indeed I was, because I was self-taught, you know, I just kind of figured out where to put my fingers and gave it a shot.
And she said you'd done it all wrong.
That's correct. So I borrowed her fingering chart and her how to play the flute book one, and went off for about 3 months and relearned to play the flute. And I'm still working on it.
That must have been very tough, relearning.
It was, yeah. Yes, exactly. Well, I first picked up the flute when I was 20, so I was a late starter. Mm. At the flute as well, and when I then finally graduated just 2 years ago to try and learn to play it properly, I was at that point 46 years old, which is kind of late to be starting for a second time.
Oh, depends
anything
on what. Anything for a laugh. Now, I must make comment with this nice little accessory that you have on today, Ian. This is the rock star, 40 plus rock star accessory, is it? Explain why you have this particular accessory.
Well, about 8 weeks ago in Lima, Peru, my lower limbs resembled those of those boys you're going to see in a few minutes. And then I had a particularly graceful balletic leap that went horribly wrong when I landed on a very wobbly stage in Peru. And it just threw me slightly sideways and I tore the ligaments in my leg. So I'm having to make this scaffolding my good friend for the next 6 to 8 months. So it's not a lot of fun. But because I'm working all the way through to the end of November.
Is that telling you something? You shouldn't be jumping around on stage working into your 40th year? Is that what it's telling you?
Not necessarily.
You're not going to deal with that.
What it's really saying is just stay the hell out of Lima, Peru, where they don't build stages.
Your skiing's out for a little while for you.
Yeah, and they've told me to give up any thoughts I ever had about being a professional footballer.
So. Oh.
But there you go. I mean, the rest of them, 4 out of 5 limbs in good working condition, who could complain? They're quick, they're quick.
With butter on camera, as well as a bit of laughter there. I'll be discreet about it. But, guys, you are touring right around Australia. You've got a new CD.
Mm.
Tell us about the new CD.
Well, the new CD is actually, we recorded it about a year ago, and because I had a solo album out last year, which was an album for the classical division of EMI Records. Then the Tull album came out, I think, at the end of August, beginning of September, and sort of staggered its way through releases in different countries as we get round to them. So it still ranks, I guess, here as a sort of a new CD, although, you know, it's about 6 months old in terms of a release. But first time playing some of those songs here in Australia on this tour.
Well, I know Australia is looking forward to it. In fact, Jethro Tull is playing Canberra, May 11. Also, there's the dates up on your screen. Sydney State Theatre, Brisbane, Melbourne, Adelaide, right around the country. Well, gentlemen, I can only say what a pleasure it is to have such a legendary rock band. Ian, Martin and I'm sorry, Andy. Andy's over there. Sorry, Andy.
That's all right. No.
You're one of the originals as well.
Yes.
Martin, aren't you?
Youngster. I'm sort of 27 years in the band.
27?
Yeah. Frightening.
But you're still loving it?
Yeah, I do, yeah. I love it. Once you've the travel's over, it's great fun.
And you're not leaping on stages with the Lima Peru as well?
Well, I'm taking it easy, sort of, you know, spinning out the years, investing in the future.
Exactly. We like it. Jethro Tull, ladies and gentlemen, please thank our guests. We'll be back with more after.